Want to use the Sumif function for adding up amounts with partial matches? Today, I'll show you how to accomplish this with a slight tweak to the traditional Sumif method. Just like this. Imagine you have a document with Apple sales, and Tim Cook asks you for the total sales of each product category. It sounds like a task made for the Sumif function, doesn't it? Let's give it a try. Open your Sumif function. Since you want the total sales of just the iPhones, the data range it should filter through is the column with the products. Let's select it and lock it with F4 so we can later drag the formula down to find the totals for the other product categories. The condition for it to filter the data is that the product contains the text iPhone, and the data to be summed is the sales. So select the column and lock it with F4. Close your formula and oops, it returns a zero. Why? Because the SUMIF function only works with exact matches. That means when the text used as a condition is exactly the same as what you have in your table. And here, no cell says just iPhone. They all include the model too. And for Excel, that's considered a different text. To have your formula accept partial matches, where the condition is that the cells contain part of the text, we'll use wildcards. But before that, don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Every week, I'll be giving away a complete Excel course worth $297 to 10 of my subscribers. Let's continue. What are wildcards? They are simply characters that give Excel additional instructions. There are several different ones, but the one we'll use in this case is the asterisk. This wildcard means any sequence of characters. So if we put one before and another after, along with ampersands to join the texts, what we're telling Excel is that the condition to sum is any sequence of characters joined with the product category, and in turn joined with any characters after the category. Or in simple words, it will sum the product category no matter what text is before or after it. Close your formula with a parenthesis, and voila, you now have the sum of all products containing the text iPhone. Now, to get the totals for the other categories, simply drag your formula down, and you have your results ready to send to Tim. You might feel like a SUMIF expert by now, but do you know how to use it with the VLOOKUP function to create one of Excel's most powerful formulas? Learn it in the next video. See you there!